We want to have same thing, but for decay phase it comes ONA. Okay, so this is about the key.
What else?
Follow me. Okay, so now I quickly I tell you, because I talked about functional polarization. So far I showed you how it functions to oxidize water, to reduce water. Now I talk about that. And also I told you how a capsule can take pick up carbon dioxide. I tell you coherence effect, very important question. This one, before I tell you, I should give little introduction. Tell me, I am sure you know that why coherence was important. Let's say we know that many compounds come in A and D form together, left hand and right. Today, in pharma company, when you have, you know, let's say some X and Y compound, many, let's say, one drug is X, ANX, okay, or DX, but always they like to come ALDX together, because it's called racemic nature. But in the medicine, maybe a particular disease where you need maybe only LX, not to, DX is unwanted, you don't need it. Maybe it will affect your body. That's why pharma company wants how to easily separate, the L and D can be separated easiest way. So in polysodic chemistry also, I demonstrate how this cluster can be used for guidance separation. This is important about that. So, what we use? We use some this kind of macrocycle. Now, this, if you see, this macrocycle is the achiral, no chiral. But once this N coordinate, you have two chiral cycles. N is, N is. Okay, then what you get? You get then acid mixture RRSS or RS, left handed and right handed. Okay, so that is what? If you put this ligand in a beaker, dissolve in water or some solution, and put some metal on it, say nickel or copper, in our case you put copper, immediately you get four isomers, two mesomer and two enantiomer RRSS. So it depends on the OH, which side, H this side or other which side. Now in this system, if you use this kind of polysolid, it is called hexa continuous resolution. I mean, the chiral separation by crystallization called spontaneous resolution. But in many, some cases, when two people are very lucky, you get only 100 crystal or 100% crystal on the 100. That will be called total spontaneous resolution. But when you get 50% that, it's called racemic or conglomerate. It's called conglomerate. So 50% left-handed, 50% right-handed. So what we got here in our case? But there's some procedure, some paper in science came, that some procedure, God knows how it will come. I mean, you have been 100 minutes of trial and error, some method it may come, 100% or 100, when pick up by orchestra. Anyway, so in our case, we did that and we could see that one crystal took the left-handed system, other crystal took the right-handed system. So I can separate mechanically by hand because that looks different. It's actually, you know, in another example in nature, the silicon dioxide, quartz has similar helical structure, left-handed, right-handed. They also come 50-50 and you can separate them mechanically by seeing under microscope. So same thing, we could do that. So, but many times you do mistake. Crystal structure, we say helical structure, we are happy. But to prove physically, you have to do that CD studies. So, you know, it's called circle diagrams. And there, you can see, it's nearly with one left handed and one right handed. So essentially, you have mixture of isomers, one crystal taking left handed, some crystal taking right handed. So you can separate the, you know, chirality by crystallizing. Okay, the very last topic I told you about the big giant cluster, because when Dr. Somit Roy was there, same group was a PhD, I was postdoc there. Okay. And we have some experience of the very big, big clusters that I have to tell you some story. It will take 5-6 minutes. Then I will come and call you. See, in Muras lab, this one compound discovered in 135, okay, this called, yesterday there was a poster session, Susovan gave one talk, he was there in Muras lab. It's called Keplerite. This group called Keplerite. This has one pentagon, any icosahedral structure, you have to have a pentagon, Where? It is what? MO6, O21, and H2O. This make one pentagon, is 6 minus charge. You see, MO6 means 32 plus charge, O42, it will give 6 minus. So, 42 minus and 36 plus, give 6 minus, no? So, 6 minus charge. Now, 12 pentagons there, so 12 into 6, you have 72 minus. Then we have 30 linker. 30 linker. In this case, linkers are MO molybdenum dimer. It has 1 plus charge. So that 30 plus give 42 minus charge. You need 42 cation to get the compound. So, but I am dealing with a compound. Before going to that story, I'll tell you a little bit about that. I told you very fast. I know a cobalt hexaqua you can put inside and get what oxygen. We thought, why you have to go a new mock? We have already zeolite, no? Inside very interesting cavity of this thing. We put cobalt inside water. But in this case, what happens when you put in the higher alkali pH, water oxygen, that cobalt is not anymore seep in the water because the pores are 5x. So it's 7 to 8x. So they come out to the pores and they make very interesting nano film like outside. What film? Alpha CO is what? Because cobalt we have water there. So cobalt and KO is we'll get the alpha CO2 nano film. And that also give very interesting, you know, this is the film on the July surface. And that again give very interesting water oxygen, which is not like our Kegel efficiency, but better than that other one, first one. We get good efficiency. This is basically, I'm talking about the material from the molecule. This one example, that's why I took it. Okay. So this, again, we got very good stability of 2000 cycle and all those things. So it is similar, so I'm not spending much time. Okay, so this one I was talking about. So this is the one we have, I'm talking pentagon, this pentagon is nothing but this one. And this is linker, can be dimer, or in this case, linker is only AP, arrow 3 plus. Iron 3 plus and O6. You know, O6 means that other oxygen linking with that. Okay. Now, this compound is known from Muras lab 1998 they discovered, and only one compound, 120 per kg. I checked by side. One compound. Can you imagine? So versatile, because even to nature, paper in nature with one compound, because it is very important magnetic object. 150 amperes electrons. So 30 iron means every iron is high spin. So 5 amperes electrons, 150 amperes in a distinct cluster. So this is very interesting thing, I am not going to that. But I am showing you, if you, you know, because one scientist, Lou Kienbulu, in America, he himself published 30 papers in JAX with this compound. Different conditions, he said, we can assemble them to nanoparticles. These clusters, you know, I talk about these clusters. These clusters again come together and make, see, I saw the small cluster came together and make a giant aggregate. It's called supernova structure. But they showed in solution. We did in a centimeters experiment where we took sodium molybdate by knowing the fact it has iron and molybdenum. We took sodium molybdate, acetic acid and perchlorate together in water, it mix just like that. Immediately we get precipitate and that has interesting a PSL picture, and you can see those, whatever you see here, you can isolate. Only difference is here they are discrete, they are not aggregated again. We get aggregation. Because in our case, the charge surface is more than this. Because it is a dilute solution, and we are using huge amount of concentration. And we are getting microglass material, this gives gas absorption. So here you cannot isolate them, we don't know what is the property. But you can do a lot of physical properties. Already we have now, we published our communication, now we are doing photon conductivity, photon reduction, all these things is coming out of this, which will not come as such this crystalline. Why it is so? Because the formula in the crystalline 12 acetate like this, and our formula we put 16 OH, then only this assembly happens. So the quick reaction at water make assemble with taking up the 16 OH. And why it is? Because even in this water they propose that OH form at the low dilute solution, that's why assemble happened. In our case, it is naturally synthesis like that, immediately forming and taking the compound 16 OH. We did DLS study, the dynamic crystalline. It tells the next sense that discharge particle. Now I tell you one thing, this compound now when you heat this fake, that amorphous compound, that make fake molecule. This is actually very important mineral in the nature, called ferrimonelite. Okay. This is again done 1963 by American mineralogy group. But they also got amorphous compound, they could not say what is this. Now I know after seeing this paper, they accepted that it is yes, what they got amorphous compound, nothing but this, you know, what we synthesize now. So they got unknowingly, but they didn't know. When they heated it, they got ferrimonelite. We also heated it, we also got fake molecule, nice nanostructures. One temperature give the rosette, one give the pen. The same thing, but two different morphology. From this paper we told, definitely nature, what that mineral form, nature iron is available as iron 3, always from many more. Molybdenum also always molybdenum. And acetic acid comes from many bacteria and soil. So we propose that in nature maybe this mineral form through this kind of big clusters, and slowly the compound goes to this mineral.
So okay. This system is they form vesicles in
vesicle. You have to have what is called APSM study of the wet compound. We don't have vesicles. We are trying to do that. We also believe this may be vesicle, but we have to prove that. We so far could not prove.
The zeta potential, it's coming around
70.6 millimol.
How stable is your...
Very stable. Because there's a value, I don't know about that, but they told that it's very stable particle, you know, in water. So it is, and that is why only difference between that American study and our study, they get that big vesicle 34 diameter nanometer, they get 100 to 250. So there is difference, and we believe this difference due to the charge is more here in this case. Now actually we generalize, because we acetic acid, we see the formula here, you know, like here. 16 OH and 4 acetic acid. Now we have compound with, this is the only condition we can get the compound out of 12 acetate, we have to have 4 acetate. Then only you can get 16 OH. Then, to prove that what we did now, because we generalize now, we use formic acid, succinic acid, malonic acid, all cases we are getting 4-4 here. So it is very general synthesis that to get OH, system will take less carbon content acid compound. Then we can get this kind of OH, and if you get OH only, then only it will be self-acid. Otherwise not. But loose salt in solution, by varying the dilution, you can manage to make OH in surface. Then they sold those areas, and you are making in situ. Okay, but we have to work more to can we vary those particle size that we have not yet done. Okay. Okay. So my summary of the talk is okay. Here one thing I did not show because the functional polyoxymetallate, water oxidation, reduction, tidal separation, and you know functional nanomaterials. I did not show you, we got water oxidation of this material also. The nanomaterial what means got material. Okay. And thank you, and if you have any questions, you can ask me.